Have you ever needed to focus on a small section of your screen recording? Let me show you how to use animations in Camtasia. While you're inside the editor and you have your content on the screen, place your playhead where you want the zoom to happen. In this case, I think I want to draw attention to this total sales graph in the middle of the screen. Well, in order to use the zoom and pan, I go over to the toolbar on the left-hand side and I choose animations. Once you choose animations, you have two options, the zoom and pan at the top and then the animations tab to the right of that. For us, we're going to focus on the zoom and pan first. Zoom and pan inside of Camtasia Windows is really helpful because it gives you a representation over here on the left of exactly what's happening on your canvas. In order to draw a zoom area into the screen, grab any one of the handles on the upper left-hand corner, bottom right-hand corner, and just drag them in so they draw attention to exactly what you want to focus on the screen. Once that happens, you'll notice that the focus changes on your canvas to the exact section that you drew focus to on the left. While that happened, you also had, down here on your timeline, an animation arrow that was drawn on your screen. How do animation arrows work in Camtasia? Well, the way it works is, as the playhead comes up to the tail of the animation process begins. Throughout the time the playhead goes over the animation arrow and reaches the head of the arrow, that's the duration of the animation itself. If the arrow is long and the playhead takes a little bit more time to go over it, the animation happens slowly or a little bit more gradually. If the arrow is shorter, that animation happens at a quicker pace. You can control how that happens by clicking on either the head of the arrow down here in the timeline or the tail of it and simply dragging it to the left or right, depending if you want it to happen faster or slower. Now, what happens after you do a zoom in, you say what you want to say in your video, there's a really good chance that you don't want to stay that tight anymore. So let's look at what it means to pull back out. If we move our playhead a little bit further down the process, make sure that media is selected there at the bottom, you can actually choose this button in the lower right-hand corner of the zoom and pan options, which says scale to fit. When I click on that, it pulls the view of your canvas and the media back to where you started and adds an additional animation arrow to your timeline that basically restores yourself back to the starting point. So if this video were to play, we will see that it zoomed in to where we needed it to be, and then zoomed out when we added that second animation arrow. If there's not enough time zoomed in, you can still control where those zooms happen by clicking and dragging on those arrows on the timeline, either to the right or to the left, depending on what kind of space you want to give it. Now, I keep using the phrase animation arrows, right? That's what's actually being applied to the timeline down here. Well, that's actually going to reference the other tab up here on the top. We have the zoom and pan tab, and we have the animations tab. When you click into the animations tab, you'll see a series of pre-built animations that Camtasia comes automatically with when you install it. But there's one in the upper left-hand corner called custom that I want to draw your attention to. A custom animation, or in technical movie making terms, a keyframe, is your ability to drag a custom animation down onto your timeline, which we will do at this point, further down the line. And what happens is Camtasia sees that there's an animation that you want to do, but nothing happens as you drag your arrow and your playhead across the arrow. Why is that true? It's because we have not given any parameters. We haven't given Camtasia any instruction as what we want it to do. So, much like these animation arrows that are automatically applied when we do the zooming and panning, we're going to use the arrow itself and the properties panel over on the right hand side. All a zoom is the changing of the scale of your screen. So if we wanted to create another zoom in effect, maybe we want to zoom in down here to this traffic by operating system or traffic by OS. What we want to do is grab the scale slider, slide it up so we're nice and zoomed in, and simply reposition the media to draw attention to exactly where we want it on our screen. And because we had that animation arrow selected, as you can see, because it is yellow down here on the timeline, Camtasia understands that that's the animation we want to have happen. We drag the playhead over that animation arrow, we zoom into where we want to be. And just like before, if we want to zoom back out, we can simply use that same effect of scale to fit, only in this case, we actually have a pre-built animation called Restore or Scale to Fit. Either one can be added to your timeline so that you can go back out to where your starting place was. If you like this video, be sure and hit that like button and subscribe for more tips and tricks to take your videos to the next level. Thanks for watching.